Sperm are unlike the other types of cells where the longer they are around and replicate, the shorter the telomeres, sperm are opposite. So older fathers have sperm with longer telomeres, and there is an effect in the offspring. So when we do studies, when we have the data to know how old was your father when you were born, that's a covariate. That's something that shapes telomere length.
And what's the effect in the offspring? Is it shorter or longer?
Yeah.
So longer. And
So sperm is telomere length is longer. Wow. And that can affect the offspring telomere length to be longer.
Are there studies that have looked at whether or not having a longer telomere length to start predicts, you know, healthy aging?
Or? Okay, so that is, I believe, and I think many of us in this field believe that that is probably one of the biggest stories out there, which is telomere length at birth, that initial setting, which we know is partly genetic, but partly prenatal environment and, you know, health of mom and dad and their their germline, you know, epigenetics. So that is one of the biggest determinants of their telomere length in late life. We all, you know, we can change it a little bit, but, you know, what you start with is a big factor. So no one has followed people to say, like, is it true that what you're born with then predicts, you know, how soon you get sick and when you die? We don't know, but we think it probably is pretty big.
So are you guys going to look at that?
Yeah, yeah.
Someone should.
Yes, absolutely.
And not just lifespan, but like you said, you know, look, does it predict cardiovascular disease? Does it predict dementia?
Well, let me tell you how important it is. National Institute of Aging, which mostly studies old people, they have started to fund, they started to say, okay, midlife determines older health, so now they fund studies of midlife, and they've even funded us and our colleagues to look at pregnancy now, to see telomere length, how it's transmitted and affected at birth from social and economic health, socioeconomic disparities, race, sex, stress, how all of those shape telomere length at birth because they believe it is going to create a healthy trajectory of aging or not. And so that's where they're investing now.